Sorry about that, folks. Had a bit of a technical problem, but we are back and rolling. And the good news is all you missed was a penalty. The Wild have 50 seconds to go and a penalty to Ryder Ralston. And they haven't scored on it yet, so it is still 6-0. Carson Lambos now will draft his way down the right wall. Punches one in. Camesso there to get it. Shoveled away to center. That goes past Spotcheck. Lucchini's the last man back. The Finlander Sorella in on him. Now Johansson driving his way ahead. Cuts back on the back-checking Kindop. Shovels one in behind the trapezoid of Camesso. Penalty expiring in 3 seconds' time. Teasdale protecting the puck. O'Leary can't scoop it up. It's jostled away from him, and out comes Ralston. And the game returns to 5-on-5 hockey with under 5 to play. Room for Ralston to run. Hits the brakes on O'Rourke. Cycles for Leipen. A wrist shot blocked in front by Johansson. Great stick battle. He outmuscles Tepley and keeps Tepley from slamming that rebound in on Volstead. An intercepted pass ahead now for Kevin Conley. The former UNO Maverick trying to turn the corner, gets it to the net. Camesso poke checks it away, but not out. Masters holds. Now Miller. Looking in behind for Cale Kessie. Spent his 10th pro season last year between Hershey and then Colorado. Got traded from the eventual Calder Cup winning Hershey Bears. Haven't brought that up with him yet. Don't want to anger the big man. And he is a big man, is Cale Kessie. In the only 30 games he played last year, due to partial injury, 107 penalty minutes. In his career, 794 PIMs in the AHL. So we'll say no more. Howarth marching in with speed, cuts back. Volstead is there, and he comes up with a tremendous save. Cale Howarth had a big burst of speed. He turned the corner, but Volstead was with him step for step. He comes up with a strong save and keeps this game 6-0. We'll go to break, 3:23 to go here in the second. Iowa up big here at home.
Season's first hole. The feel of the jig as it flutters on the fall. And the exhilaration of seeing real-life monsters appear. Game on is getting closer. Are you ready? Shields.
Jesper Volstead, a flash of brilliance on a semi-breakaway by Cale Howarth a moment ago as we reset for a face-off to his right. Rockford will begin their AHL regular season out west in San Jose next weekend, a pair of games against the Barracuda. Wild were out there last season. Saw their beautiful brand new building. Very high tech in a very high tech city of San Jose. Wild control the D zone face off. What a night for Pavel Novak. Novak, who had a lone assist in the win on Wednesday. Much more so on the forefront of offense here tonight is Novak with a goal and an assist. Beckman has room, fleeing into the right circle on his backhand, slides one across. And it was either the skate of McDougal or the paddle of Camesso that kept that away from an easy tap in on the back post. That would have been Novak again. Andrew Parrott now. Gagne has it pushed to center where Del Mastro drives it ahead. Lettieri looks skyward. He wanted to knock that puck down before it got deep, but Sammy Walker gets to it first. No icing. Walker reverts it back to the near side where Lettieri can't get there. Nice breakout pass by Del Mastro. And Kindop spikes it in behind the net. A thrashing by O'Rourke, a centering feed, and Gagne is denied point blank by Jesper Volstead again. Well, undoubtedly, when you get up 6-0 in a game, you might slightly let off the gas. Iowa has done that, and with that alleviation of the pressure, Rockford's found a little foothold here, but the problem is they've ran directly into the wall of Jesper Volstead, who has been at his busiest here in the latter stages of this second period now. Rockford had 4 shots in the first. They have 9 here in the second. Iowa, 17 second period shots. They've scored 4 times on those 17 tries. They had 9 in the first. In total, 26-13 right now. The shots on Wednesday were 35-20 in favor of Iowa. Now Louis Crevier. D to D, Del Mastro. That one hit Johansson on its way to Cage. And Patan, a picture-perfect saucer pass, and I mean perfect for Johansson, right back rink wide to Sammy Walker, dragging his way in behind the net. Now Walker behind the net. It's Lettieri scanning, pulls it away. Lettieri will cycle. That hit a skate of a referee on its way in. That was Jared Cummins. But this top line of Iowa, sensational tonight. They have not given the puck up. Walker almost finding Lettieri, who was surfing in near to Camesso. The pressure remains. Iowa relentless on the forecheck. Lettieri gives one up cheaply, and then he sprints backwards to get it back. That'll make his grandpa Lou Nanny proud. Very well-known luminary of hockey up in the state of Minnesota. Former general manager of the Minnesota North Stars, and when it comes to hockey in Minnesota, few know more than Lou Nanny. Even lesser known, maybe, though, about Vinny Lettieri. More pro sport bloodlines than just his grandfather, Lou. His dad, Tino Lettieri, starred for the Minnesota Kicks, professional soccer in Minnesota once upon a time. Want to talk about being born to be a pro athlete? Well, that's one family that has it in spades. A lot of Nannies and Lettieris out there that have had some pro hockey or pro sport acumen, that's for sure. 24 seconds to go here in the second period. Greg Morellis took a punishing hit by DJ King there. Morellis took a scan too and saw who hit him. See if that comes around. We've seen one fight tonight. Nyhoff and Dornbach danced earlier in this game. 5 seconds to go in the period, and one last look ahead by Maniscalco, and the buzzer will sound, but lots of bleeding here in the second for this Rockford team as the Wild pour 4 more goals on. It's a 6-0 rout through 40 minutes of action here tonight in downtown Des Moines. We'll take a breather, and when we come back, who I was just talking about, Vinny Lettieri will join us down on the bench. A goal and 3 assists tonight. We'll talk about his Iowa Wild debut and more as our coverage of Wild hockey continues here on YouTube.
Watching the season's first hole. The feel of a jig as it flutters on the fall. And the exhilaration of seeing real-life monsters appear. Game on is getting closer. Are you ready? Shields.
is you. And you are why we do what we do. Each and every one of you are wonderful, amazing people. So we'll treat you that way on your journey of trusted care. Because the way you, and you feel matters. Unity Point Health. Know how much you matter to this world.
Holes are punched, jigs are tipped, and the crew's assembled. May the heavy lifting begin. It's time to walk on water. Shields. The feeling of loading up the night before. Punching the season's first hole. The feel of the jig as it flutters on the fall. And the exhilaration of seeing real life monsters appear. Game on is getting closer. Ready? Shields.
A deluge of offense on the way tonight. Six total goals through two periods of action here at Wells Fargo Arena. Ben Gislason welcoming you back to downtown Des Moines. And what an onslaught of offense it has been. And a big key to this 6-0 lead. 4 points on the night for Mr. Vinny Letteri, who is joining us now down rinkside on the bench. Vinny, your first time in an Iowa Wild sweater. It certainly has been a prolific night. I know it's the preseason, but scoring never gets old, no matter even if it doesn't count, does it? The trio of Nick Patan, Sammy Walker, and Vinny Letteri. Obviously, you guys haven't had a ton of time getting to know each other. You did a little bit while you were up at Minnesota Main Camp together. But what do you like most about this trio? Because you guys seem like fast friends. It's been pretty connected to watch.
It's pretty easy when you have the craftiness that they do to work with them. And like I said, they work really hard, so that's probably the most important part.
You grew up a Minnetonka skipper north of us here in the state of Minnesota. What did you know about Des Moines before making your way down here? And I know it hasn't been long, but what have you made of the city of Des Moines so far, Vinny?
I've just known about the cornfields on the way down. But no, I don't know much, but it's great. It's a nice place. I think we have an apartment coming right downtown here, and it looks really nice. And over in West Des Moines, there's a lot to do over there, and a lot of great restaurants in that mall. So it's been nothing but great since we gotten down here, and the staff's been really helpful. The guys are really great, and I think it just speaks to the organization of Minnesota itself. It's just everyone's welcoming, and they want to be as close as they can off the ice to bring the chemistry on the ice.
Well, Vinny, there certainly has been a lot of chemistry, not only between your trio, but this entire team tonight. It's been fun to watch. Good luck in the third period, and we're looking forward to seeing more of you, whether you're here with the Minnesota Wild this season. Thanks for this time.
Yeah, thank you very much.
That's Vinny Letteri, the maestro tonight. He sure has been super, hasn't he? Sammy Walker, a boatload of points. Nick Patan. There's been scoring all over the lineup, hasn't there been here this evening? So we will, from here, go to another Future Faces as we'll check in. We heard from Carson Lambos, one of our rookie players this season in the first intermission. Now we're here in the second, and we'll hear from Caden Bank here, who's currently injured but making his way back from injury. Should see him before the first half of the season is over. Let's learn more about the former WHL standout in Caden Bank here.
I like to play a 200-foot game a little bit more with the offensive flair. Obviously, I love scoring goals, so who doesn't? So the more time you can spend in the offensive zone, the less time you spend in the defensive zone. It's a recipe for success. Growing up, my favorite player was Jonathan Toews, Chicago, so a bit awkward in that sense. But, yeah, I just loved the way he played growing up. I don't know. Everyone's been saying Taylor Swift in all these videos I've been seeing lately, so I'm not going to say that. So I don't know. Maybe like Firework, Katy Perry. It's pretty go-to. I'd love to know what people were thinking. I think it's just cool. That way you can be more in-depth with them. It's not just icebreaker questions. You can go more in-depth and learn more about them, what they're thinking. A boat and a paddle in water. Get me off the island. I'm going to choose the eagle. Get to fly around and soar above people and get a nice bird's eye view. I actually had a tryout when I was younger. Probably had to been 13 or 14. And I had skate guards on and just walked right out there with the skate guards on. That was a good start. I got cut, probably for that reason. So, Family Feud. I watched that a lot. My grandma would always go over to my grandparents' house, and it was always on. So, I watched pretty closely. So, I think I would know the answers and what not to say. Oh, dog for sure. Had some bad run-ins with cats over the years. So, we're going to go dog all the way. I don't know. I grew up on, like, Mario Kart and, like, Wii Sports. So, maybe something. Probably not Wii Sports, but, like, probably, like, Mario or something like that. I'm a big Drake fan. He doesn't seem to miss, so he's always putting out good songs. So, I think that would be a safe bet. I'm pretty big... pretty big into mountain biking. I like biking. I like going out there and hitting trails, so I don't know if many people would know that about me. The roller coaster of a hockey journey, I don't know. We would have to work on the title, but we just have to do something with the roller coaster, all the ups and downs probably.
I'm a two-way defenseman, good skater. My defensive game is what takes priority, but I still like to add into the offense. Dustin Byfuglien. I grew up watching the Jets, and he was just a beast. He was a man amongst boys in the NHL, so it was just so much fun watching him.
A night of working out the kinks continues. Thanks for taking in a little bit of Caden Banker. And if you missed Carson Lambos in the first intermission, you might have caught a little bit of Lambo there during the second as well. As we look forward towards the third period of play, this Wild team has come out punching in bunches tonight. A 6-goal lead thanks to a boatload of goal scorers here this evening. Lots of guys with 3 points, 4 points, 2 points. It's been a big evening of offense. And the question coming in was, would this team that has so much offensive firepower, would they deliver? It's very early, but certainly right now it looks like this team has the capability of running the gamut offensively. They've done so quite effectively so far against this Rockford IceHog team. Through 5 periods of play now, they are outscoring the IceHogs 12-2, and they haven't given up much against either, although Jesper Volstead did have himself a very nice period there towards the end. I mentioned it towards the tail end of our stanza. Seemed like the Wild were maybe reining the horses in a little bit. Volstead did start to see a little more action. And for a goaltender, that can be difficult sometimes. All of a sudden, you have to be forced into action. You're seeing your teammates scoring a lot of goals. You're not only seeing goals being scored, but you're seeing your teammates really not give the puck up either. It was offense all night long. It was puck possession. Then all of a sudden, Jesper was sprung into action. And he did a nice job, came up with some big saves. So as we get ready to go to break here, I believe we're set to go to commercial. When we come back, John Schaefer and I, we will deliver more on this second period, which saw a lot of goals. That is the mantra so far for this team, score and score and score. As we're on our way to break, when we come back, John Schaefer and I will break down that period here in Des Moines, where it's 6-0 Iowa over Rockford.
The feeling of loading up the night before. Punching the season's first hole. The feel of the jig as it flutters on the fall. And the exhilaration of seeing real life monsters appear. Game on is getting closer. ready? Shields.
Is you. And you are why we do what we do. Each and every one of you are wonderful, amazing people. So we'll treat you that way on your journey of trusted.
Feeling of loading up the night before. The season's first hole. The feel of the jig as it flutters on the fall. And the exhilaration of seeing real life monsters appear. Game on is getting closer. Are you ready? Shields.
Yeah. See, there's some key players that are missing. But I go back to a little bit of what I was talking about at the end of that second period. Let's throw the score sheet out of it. Let's throw the 6-0 deluge of offense out of it. And let's just talk about what we've seen. And that is a team that is playing well beyond its years in connectivity. You're seeing all five players involved. You're seeing an extremely active decor. Kyle Masters is filtering into the high slot. David Spotcheck is working down the wall. This is a really mobile unit. I mean, you look at any of these defensemen, they can all skate, and a lot of them can skate extremely well. And Brett McLean clearly is not shy about getting his defensemen involved in the rush, which ask any NHL team that has success, and they all have D that are successfully offensive. You have to have at least a few of them. Iowa has a mobile decor. They all want to be involved. They all want to be engaged. It's a high-pressure situation where they're coming down the wall. They're pinching. They're keeping the lid on the zone extremely well, and it's so fun to watch.
Absolutely a great time to watch. I do have to mention Rockford, as you've said, don't have all of their weapons. They also have to find a way to make up for some scorers from last year. Rocco Grimaldi, no longer part of this squad, if I recall. Lucas Reichel now up top with Chicago currently, I believe, if I'm not mistaken there too, Ben. And so when you lose players like that, it's tough. But let's talk more about this Wild team. I love the net front presence from this team. We saw a lot of great puck movement across the offensive zone on the Pavel Novak goal in particular. And then he's in a grinder area and buries one.
Pavel Novak is, under the surface, one of the best performers tonight. He's had an outstanding game. He's done more than just add a goal and an assist, which is plenty on a given night, especially for a rookie forward like he has done. And I just can't help but think about what he must be thinking right now. This is a guy who has got his cancer diagnosis. I'm sure he had to wonder, am I ever going to play hockey again? And here he is playing under the bright lights of Wells Fargo Arena, and not only playing, but succeeding. It's a wonderful story. He clearly is a guy that has a very good career ahead of him, and I'm looking forward to seeing more of what Pavel Novak has to offer. Adam Beckman has looked really good. Sammy Walker's up to his old tricks again. And it's a team that has a lot of offensive upside, and we've seen it tonight. And with the way they're playing, it seems like it's sustainable. Now, it's not going to be six goals every night, but this does seem like a team that's probably going to get their wins this season by flexing their offensive muscles. And I thought that coming in, and now that we've seen it in the flesh, it seems like it's going to be the way to get the job done this year.
Still have Fogarty to mix in. You still got Dakota Mermis to mix in. Keep in mind, this lineup would be stellar any night of the week, but then you mix in some vets. Really exciting stuff
well,
to see.
Jujhar Kara, too. Don't forget yes. about him. My goodness, guy's got over 300 National League games. I mean, it's insane.
Absolutely. And this tons of depth for Coach McClain to play with. Excited to see what happens here in the third and to see what we get out of this team. When we come back, we'll get you the highlights and the start of the third period. Good stuff, Ben.
You too.
Watching the season's first hole. The feel of the jig as it flutters on the fall. And the exhilaration of seeing real life monsters appear. Game on is getting closer. Are you ready? Shields.
Countdown is on to our finale of the preseason. If the rust isn't shaken off by now, it may never come off. And this Iowa team certainly has not looked very rusty. No WD-40 needed for this club. They are rolling on all cylinders tonight and in this preseason. 6-0 they lead coming into the final frame here as we welcome you back to Wells Fargo Arena. Ben Gislason ready to bring you our climax of the evening. Teams will flip ends one more time. And Mike O'Leary will begin this third period against Bryce Kindop. Lloydminster, Alberta versus Halifax, Nova Scotia. The Albertan wins it, and we're off into the third. Enjoy. Gagne takes a thumping hit. 13 seconds in, another one thrown by O'Leary, this time on Nyhoff. Might see a more steady dosage of this line here in the third with the lead very much intact. Maybe less of Lettieri, Walker, and Patan, who've already had themselves a feast offensively tonight. Kindop misses on a bid. Miller in the way, and it's pounded back in by McDougal. Well, I'm eating my words now. Here they come. Patan with Walker and Lettieri. Patan misses on Masters. Now Lettieri will look for a dump in. Misses on that. Walker back for O'Rourke. A skied backhander from Lettieri bounces into Drew Commesso. He'll paddle it to his left. Parrott's intercepted. Nick Patan has looked energetic tonight. I talked about it in Rockford. You never quite know what you're going to get from the veteran types, and two of Iowa's five veterans listed on their roster on this line in Lettieri and Patan. But they have looked engaged, they have looked active, and obviously prolific. And a Rockford goal at that is Michael Tepley receives a backdoor feed from Matu Spodniak, and the IceHogs find the scoreboard. 6-1 here with 18:26 to go in the third. Bit of a breakdown defensively there. 2-on-1 rush. It was executed well by the backhand feed here of Tepley. Let's see it again. Sprawling was Johansson, and O'Rourke with a skyward look, knowing he got caught a little out of position there. And so Rockford ends the perfect night of Jesper Volstead. And we'll reset at center ice, 6-1. Now Maniscalco. meanders his way into offensive territory, jolted off the puck, floated to center. Beckman got tripped up at the line. Maniscalco bouncing in on Beckman, coming to support him is Ryder Ralston. He's met by two Wild players, intercepted by Lambos at the blue line, and his trigger pull finds the glove of Camesso. Wild and IceHogs had a marvelous, marvelous series last year. Oodles of overtime games, both teams with some dramatic wins in overtime. Some come-from-behind victories, and of course, a pulse-pounding best-of-three series in the opening round of the Calder Cup playoffs, where Rockford scored twice in overtime to win the best-of-three series, once in Rockford and then once at home here. The season ended at the end of April here in the Game 2 of the playoffs. Buddy Robinson ended that game in overtime. It was Rocco Grimaldi who ended it two nights prior out in Rockford in Game 1. And as John Schaefer mentioned during our intermission chat, those are two players that did put some offense on the board, specifically Grimaldi, who came over at the deadline from San Diego and was a big part of the offense for Rockford in their sprint towards playoffs. And now the question is, who will make up for some of those lost points? You do still have David Gust. You do still have Luke Philp, who will be back from injury, I think, before the halfway point, I've been told. Brett Cini as well, still in the fold for Rockford. As Nyhoff got tangled up with another Wild player there. This time it was Kevin Conley. Here is Nyhoff. Masters does a good job to gap across and get a stick on that wrist shot. Mike O'Leary. And behind his own net, Masters ties up his man. Nyhoff joins and pins the puck against the dasher here. Just announced a crowd of 2,300 tonight here for a preseason game in Des Moines. This fan base wows on a frequent basis. Again, Nyhoff is in the middle with a man. That one goes off the post from Gagne, bottom of the right circle, and getting to it at the point is Lipin. Rockford's found a little step here in the third. Lipin looking back door, and that's angled wide. I think it was O'Leary who was there where he needed to be. He ramped it wide. Lipin would have had a nice angle at a tip-in to make this a 6-2 game had O'Leary not been there. Frolicking ahead is Tepley. Buzzes the bell tower of Volstead all the way out through center, and Walker will spill this in just shy of 5 minutes into this third period. The Wild up 6-2. Now it's Maniscalco flashing in. Drops to his backhand, whistles one across. Tepley with time. Volstead, the shoulder save. And there's a rebound chance that was never put on goal. Defended well by Nick Patan. Letary takes a high stick from Tepley. And that hit him in the chin. Looks like he's all right as far as teeth go. His wife will be happy about that, but Letary caught one in the chin, and Tepley will go for high sticking. Well, Jesper Volstead bouncing right back after that most recent goal of Rockford got behind him, though there was nothing Volstead could have done on the goal by Spodniak. And Iowa's power play will go back to work. They are 1-for-1 on the evening. Pardon, 1-for-2. It is a third trip now to the man advantage here with 5:15 to play in this third period and final period of the preseason. Spacek in for Lucchini, slams it off the right pad of Camesso, who's had a perfect night so far. Pardon, one's gotten past him. The Johansson goal beat him back the second half of the second period. Now Kyle Masters has his pocket picked by Lipin. He'll step in and fires one off the mask of Jesper. And that's a little bit of that youth showing for this Wild team. The turnover deep in your own zone on the power play, not something you see often, and it's all a part of the growing pains that will happen. As highly skilled as Masters is, as Lambos is, as Spacek is, some of these youngsters, there will be mistakes that get made that do cost you goals. That's just part of being a young defenseman in the American Hockey League. All those players listed. Masters 20, Lambos 20, Spacek 20. Think about what you were doing at 20 years of age. I know what I was doing. It wasn't keeping yourself at tip-top shape and handling yourself like a pro. These guys are having to do a lot. That's why you go to the AHL. It really is, especially for highly touted defensemen. It is a polishing school. And these players will hope to add polish to games that already have a lot of luster in them. This power play has been a rather boring one. Masters, a great pass ahead, zipped into Beckman. He'll leave it for Walker, across for Patan, and a great save by Kemeso, who came dealing across. Patan for Lettieri. His one-timer had some snap on it, but it's gloved by the former BU Terrier. And he holds tight with 13:08 to play in the third. We'll take another breather. More hockey still to be played in Des Moines. 6-1 Wild lead here at Wells Fargo Arena.
Was it the falling leaves? Or us falling in love with every turn? Every landscape, a tapestry of color. Bluebird skies. A Christmas. And beauty that filled the country. And longing for both the past and the future. And the memories yet to come. Explore Minnesota.
Clogbusters is the only premier drain cleaning service company in Central Iowa. From drain assessments to sewer repair, Clogbusters will make sure the job is done with care and quality in mind to make sure it's done right. Our pet-friendly team will always provide the care you deserve, and we can offer a two-year warranty. Don't wait until the problem gets worse. Call us today at 265-CLOG. Again, 265-CLOG to schedule an appointment.
Third period rolling along here on YouTube. Thanks for joining us here this evening. This Wild team showcasing their high-class offense, something that Wild fans all over will hope continues into the regular season, which is set to begin at 7 p.m. on Friday night, Friday the 13th, nonetheless. Entering into spooky season here in October. PSA for anybody tuning in from outside of the state of Iowa. Google Beggar's Night. B-E-G-G-A-R-S. Beggar's Night. Something that I learned early on in my tenure here in Des Moines, coming up on now 6 years here in Des Moines. Actually, it'll be coming up on seven. Boy, I'm dating myself now. Wild actually and their fans here in Des Moines celebrate Halloween a night early. Trick-or-treating happens October 30th here in Des Moines. Find another place in the country that does that. My first season here when I was working in junior hockey, saw trick-or-treaters walking around on the 30th, and I could not figure out what was happening. It was quite a sight. But it has come to be a night I certainly look forward to every year. Get to spend it at home as well this year, not always the case. As there's an icing call against the Wild here. Rockford has found a bit of life here in this third period, and it's hard internally to not even accidentally let up off the gas after 40 minutes of a stranglehold the Wild have had on this game. One-year-old out of Kelowna. Jalen Lipin wins the faceoff. Tepley with a razor on the net. That one's shouldered away by Jesper Volstedt. Del Mastro shaking his way backwards along for Spodniak, who has the lone tally for Rockford tonight. Lipin on the forecheck. Aerially knocked loose by Spacek. Lipin keeps the play alive. Tepley battling with O'Rourke. Nice reach from Ryan, but he loses his stick, kicks it along for Spacek. An inventive breakout by the young D pair, and it's out at center. Dornbach can't strip Sorella. Morellis runs him out of real estate. Big hit by Spacek, thrown on Spodniak. Spacek lost it at the blue line. Could be a breakaway for Sorella. He scores. Two straight for Rockford. It's Antti Sorella who gets behind Carson Lambos after a turnover at neutral. And Rockford slowly but surely starting to find a pulse here in the third. First of the preseason for the 22-year-old out of Finland. Nice finish under the blocker for the fourth round pick of the Hawks in 2019. Definitely someone that the Hawks have a keen eye on. Who will be a part of this IceHogs team this season, coming over from Lukko, where he played in his home country of Finland in Liiga. One of the top European pro leagues you can play in, especially as a 21-year-old. Well, and one thing that Iowa did in Rockford, the game out there wasn't nearly as dominating through the opening 40 minutes as we've seen here tonight. But the other thing that has happened tonight that did not happen in Rockford, when the IceHogs found some pushback, and they did on that Wednesday night game, Iowa did not take long to push back and take the momentum, take the control of the game right back. The Wild have let this one slip a little bit here in the third. We haven't seen that backbone, that posture that we saw from Iowa on Wednesday, and that is something I can only imagine Brett McLean is probably saying on the bench, is probably going to at least talk about. He won't have liked the way his team has played here in the third. And it's, again, human nature, you're going to see a little bit of a let-up happen when you're up 6-0 going into the third period. But habits still can't change. You can't change the way you play. You may change the way you attack. You might not have as much gusto on the forecheck. But in the D zone specifically, Iowa has been a little bit lackluster here in the third period. And that's something that Brett McLean and his staff will undoubtedly be keeping tabs on and address at some point here tonight or the rest of the weekend. The team will practice on Sunday, gearing up for the weekend ahead. Now Johansson's one-time blast. That one had a vapor trail behind it, turned aside by Comesso. Johansson across, finds the skate of Patan looking in front. Walker was there, missed him, and then King throws a cross check on Walker. I'd imagine someone on a Wild bench caught that. That may not come around tonight, but if King winds up in a Rockford IceHogs sweater this season, taking liberties on a top-line player like that, hockey players have very long memories. Cale Howarth dicing his way in. Nifty move still with it is Howarth. Poke check of Spacek seals that play into the far corner. Under 10 to play now here in this third period, and a puck with a life of its own ends up going out of play. Lucky kiddo over there going home with a souvenir. And a break in the action is on the way here in Des Moines. 9:54 to play in the third. Rockford finding some jump, but it's still 6-2. Wild on top. Show us your
move. Feeling of loading up the night before. Watching the season's first hole. The feel of the jig as it flutters on the fall. Exhilaration of seeing real life monsters appear. Game on is getting closer. Are you ready? Shields.
At the steely eyes of Brett McLean on the bench and his new staff, who have to be happy with what they've seen so far in two preseason games. And what they've seen is gigantic offense A very intriguing group for McLean and company to handle. McLean, who was here in Des Moines as an assistant for three seasons, one under Derek Lalonde, now head coach of the Detroit Red Wings, and then two seasons with Tim Army. And McLean taking over for his former head coach. Jesper Volstead coming up with a good stop on a pseudo two-on-one rush there after a big hit got thrown by Michael Leary right in front of the bench of McLean. Looked like O'Leary was out for a little more than just a casual body check there. He had somebody in mind on that hit. All a part of the rich story that will be this series. It was such an interesting one last season. I brought up the Wild and Ice Hogs will play this season 14 times. Last year, including those two high, high pressure playoff games, 16 times these teams played. And there were just storylines littered in that series. Players that had had one-on-one battles all year long. All kinds of drama. We'll see what this year's edition of it has in store. Nobody has played the Wild more in their 11-year history than Rockford. 9:07 to play here in the third. Wild setting up shop in the offensive zone. Kyle Masters drifts one wide of the net. Picked up by Dornbach. Back for Masters. Hard play on his backhand. Settles it down and dribbles it down below the goal line. Crevier turns one over for Rockford. Dornbach in front. Sorello's the only one home. Sorella weaving his way in, one on two. Antti Sorella behind the net. Tried to wave one in front. That was stood up and then cleared away by the Wild. Is this icing? Yes, it is. With 8:33 to play in the third. Shots in total, 32 for Iowa, 23 for Rockford. Here in the third, though, the Ice Hogs out shooting Iowa 9-6. It'll be Lucchini against Sorella here. Masters staples his man to the glass in Maksimovic. Point shot from Parrott. That hit a man in front in Miller, who's had a nasty streak in his game tonight. Maksimovic on the left-hand wall. Good stick lift from Beckman and away to center and a two-on-one coming. Lucchini with Novak. Lucchini finds a late arriving Masters. He tried to go back to Lucchini. Pass was behind Jake, though, and that results in a turnaround rush by Rockford the other way. Ralston's wrist or a limp one stopped easily by Volstead. And now O'Rourke and Maksimovic will get friendly in the corner. Oh, there was a late something thrown by Maksimovic and O'Rourke, as I talked about in the second, that violent streak he plays with. He turned right around and went right after Maksimovic. So the Hamilton Ontarian was an OHL champion with Erie in 2017. With a little snarl here late in the third. And reciprocating happily, number 22 in white, Ryan O'Rourke. Brought up his partner, Simon Johansson, and the fabulous end to his season that Johansson had. He was plus 11 in his final 16 games. His partner, Ryan O'Rourke, of course, if your partner has a great plus-minus streak going, you probably do too. The same for O'Rourke. In the final 19 games of the season, the Pickering Ontarian was a plus 14. A Wild team that really had a great run down the stretch. Very streaky Wild team a season ago. Had a record 14-game point streak. December into January, that rolled all the way to the end of the month. That was stopped in Rockford, actually, at the beginning of February. As a chance develops, and a goal for Bryce Kindop. And it's 6-3, and This Rockford team has started moving downhill, and the snowball that's gathering here is getting bigger and bigger as the Ice Hogs have cut the lead in half. That one just goes off O'Rourke's skate right onto the tape of Kindop, who was alone. A nice finish there by the Albertan. And so this Ice Hog team, unlike Wednesday night, they have some gusto left. They're not lying down here in the third period. This is a 6-3 hockey game now, as Maniscalco will drop one in. And Lambos will go D to D for spot check. And again, looking at this lineup, looking at the way this team is built, this might be a little bit of what we see this season. Iowa scoring and maybe giving up goals in bunches. When you have young D, there are mistakes that will happen that won't happen when you have an older D core. And this Wild fan base used to a bit of an older group. When you think about some of the players that were on last year's team on the back end, Joe Hicketts, as veteran as they come, Turner Ottenbright on that blue line. Dakota Mermis obviously not in the lineup tonight, but he'll settle things down a bit and would be a huge factor in a game like this where all of a sudden your lead goes away by three in rapid fashion. So 6-3 here in Des Moines. Brendan Miller setting up shop now. In the high slot for Teasdale, who had his shot blocked and then he pancaked Spodniak after blocking it. Lipen gets it back for Rockford. Misses Del Mastro, who sails back into his own zone. Del Mastro cutting away from the forechecking Dornbach. Veered over for Spodniak. Lets it go to Crevier with 6:05 to play. Here in the finale of preseason, Rockford begins their regular season journey in San Jose next weekend. The Wild here in Des Moines against the Silver Knights of Henderson. AHL affiliate of the Stanley Cup champion Vegas Golden Knights. Now Tepley. It's been a big part of this third period push of Rockford. Tepley rambling his way, circling the zone, step for step with him, Kyle Masters. Terrific work there by the 20-year-old. As Sorella drops one ahead, O'Rourke with a nice gap, he'll pound it in. Up ahead is Maksimovich. O'Rourke watching him with a vengeful eye. Maksimovich, a good pass across. McDougal looking to center off a skate. Maksimovich gets to it. Darting his way down towards the circle, leaves it for Ryder Rolston, who cuts back on a dime. Prancing in is Rolston in front, looking for a backdoor pass. It's blocked away by Volstead's paddle. He had McDougal there, and Iowa clears it out to neutral. Rockford feeling it here in the third. The shots on goal as we move into the final five, 13-6 here in the third period with the edge to Rockford. O'Rourke ahead. Beckman does get a piece of it, say the linesman. A wraparound met by Lambos. Down for Walker. Towards the goal line looking for Lettieri. Patan back with it. Finds Carson Lambos drooping in. Couldn't get the shot off. Walker circling towards the net, gloved by Camesso. And he'll hold tight to that with 4:22 to play in the third. Our final media timeout means our final break. We're back with the finale next of this 6-3 game here at Wells Fargo Arena.
Was it the falling leaves? Or us falling in love with every turn? Every landscape, a tapestry of color. Bluebird skies. Christmas and beauty that fuel the future and longing for both the past and the future and the memories yet to come. Explore Minnesota.
Clogbusters is the only premier drain cleaning service company in Central Iowa. From drain assessments to sewer repair, Clogbusters will make sure the job is done with care and quality in mind to make sure it's done right. Our pet-friendly team will always provide the care you deserve, and we can offer a two-year warranty. Don't wait until the problem gets worse. Call us today at 265-CLOG. Again, 265-CLOG to schedule an appointment.
6-3 hockey game here inside of Wells Fargo Arena. Just under 6 minutes to play. We'll have a full post-game report with Ben Gisselson and I after this one wraps up. Let's get back up top.
Thank you, John. A little bit of a leak in the dam for Iowa here in the third. They have given up three after coming in with a 6-0 lead. It has been made 6-3 by Matus Spodniak. They gave that one to Tepley. That's a Spodniak goal, I'm positive. Antti Sorella gets the second at 8:23, and Bryce Kindop at 12:31 has given Rockford something to go home on the bus and think, hey, we got a little mojo going. Ozone faceoff for Iowa here. O'Leary wins it. Something that we grew familiar with last year. O'Leary was the go-to faceoff man. In fact, at times they started him on the power play just to win a faceoff, then he left. And Camesso gobbles one up here, and Cale Kesey goes right after Logan Nyhoff. Well, remember when I was talking about earlier about long memories, Nyhoff has been in the middle of a lot tonight, and Kesey saying no more. Well, looking at the lineup of Rockford, you wonder who would potentially be a potential partner for Cale Kesey. Once upon a time, it would have been Dmitry Osipov, but that was back in the day when Cody McLeod was dueling Dmitry Osipov a few moons ago. Maybe Marcel, not in the lineup tonight for this Rockford team. He does stand at 6'4", 242. There was a massive collision between Kesey and Marcel out in Rockford. Wish we would have had video of it. It was a collision to remember. Although Marcel, not a penalty minute gatherer of huge proportions when he was in junior at Gatineau in the QMJHL, a league where actually you can no longer fight in without, I believe, a suspension. Dornbach looks to finish his check on Maniscalco and does. Flopped ahead. Nyhoff springing a man in Kindop, trying to catch him as Morellis, and he takes a penalty, but one he had to take. Kindop had gotten behind the Wild defense again, and in the second period, I talked about Iowa's aggressive play at the blue line. They're frequently pinching their D, which means the defensemen are encouraged to come down the wall, even when Rockford has possession. It's been an extremely aggressive unit. Now, when you're a defenseman at the blue line and you're going to make that play, you have to take a scan to the middle of the ice and look for a forward that's covering you, or else you likely don't make that pinch because it would mean an odd man rush against the other way. There's been a few gambles tonight that Iowa has made at the blue line where that forward has been in the vicinity but not quite there. Morellis was not quite there on that pinch, and that's why he had to hustle back to recover after, I believe it was Nyhoff, who lofted an area pass out through center and sprung Kindop. It was a nice play from Nyhoff. But all a part of the feeling out process and all a part of understanding each other and working in unison, which Iowa has done so well with the puck tonight. Without it, they're still working on it, which is to be understood, certainly. Good save from Jesper on a blast by Sorella after that puck just bounced its way onto the tape of the Finlander. Volstead holds on there. Sorella and Volstead would have played against each other for their fellow countries at the World Junior Championships in 2020. Volstead for Sweden and Sorella for Finland, obviously. So Morellis in the box for holding here as the Wild look to sort out this power play of Rockford. Lambos coming way out to deflect a point shot by Tepley. Don't see that too often, but one thing we have seen often tonight is the gap and steady defending of Carson Lambos. That has stood out to me, his ability to read the play, his ability to be in the right spot at the right time. Was on the ice for that Sorella goal, but that's it so far on the night of Carson Lambos. Was out for a goal four as well, was Carson. Power play continuing for just under 90 seconds now. Maniscalco back to the half wall. Here's Gagne looking to the net. That misses both Sorella and Howarth. Sorella to get it. Wheels one up the wall. Gagne drops it. Sorella now looking diagonally. Good spot. David Spotcheck gets a piece of that puck, and it rolls back to the hands of Comesso. Quickly ramped ahead. Gagne feeds one in deep. Howarth spins into Johansson, who's just eating this puck, killing precious seconds on this Rockford power play. Just their second of the game. Now it's Nardella. And a penalty coming up here, I believe, on Iowa. After spilling to the ice was Howarth as he was trying to crash his way to the paint, so it'll be a 5-on-3. As holding court along the wall is Nick Nardella, whose father, Bobby, you might remember, a legend with the Des Moines Buccaneers, 111 points for Bobby Nardella one season. And the whistle sounds as the Wild touch the puck. 30 seconds to go in Morales' minor means 30 seconds of 5-on-3 as Ryan O'Rourke takes a trip to the penalty box for tripping. And a timeout has been called by Anders Sorensen. So the tense not folding of Rockford. 2 minutes to go in this third period. You only need 3 goals. And so Anders Sorensen trying to bring out a bit of late magic here in this third period with a 5-on-3. So a Rockford team that has poured on 18 shots here in the third period, completely changing the scope of this game. It looked like they were dead and buried, these Ice Hogs. They have come alive here in the third. Iron three for Iowa will be Jake Lucchini, David Spotcheck, and Carson Lambos. A little baptism by fire for Lambos and Spotcheck here. A lot of ice for the team in red. Maniscalco at the blue line. Along for Del Mastro's one-timer, stopped a second chance. Great save, Volstead, and the open net was missed by Nardella on the far side. But Volstead, in the midst of the chaos, had a huge stop. He makes another one on a boomer by Maniscalco, and the crowd says thank you. Jesper Volstead, the pad work he brings every night is astounding. There are times when those legs of his come out of absolute thin air to make saves, and that is what we just saw in front of our eyes on that last chance right in front. And a look at the empty net, and Carson Lambos has his first, and it's 7-3. Rockford looking to try and throw the kitchen sink at Iowa, and I talked about gambling earlier. Rockford gambles, and Carson Lambos gets some love from the Wells Fargo Arena ice, a bouncing puck that rolls and churns and bounces its way into the yawning cage. So Lambos has his first in a Wild uniform. And Iowa is able to officially put this one to bed. 4 seconds to go in the penalty to Morales. Then it'll be just over 1:30 to play in the O'Rourke minor and 1:42 to play in the hockey game here. The finale of the preseason, Iowa set to go a perfect 2-0 and score a whopping 13 goals. So back comes Morellis, who's a key factor to the penalty kill, and he's set to just stay out and get the job done here with his mates, Brendan Miller, Kyle Masters, and Michael Leary, as Maniscalco leaves one back for the Slovakian-born Spodniak. D3 college hockey in his past, played for Adrian. I'll give the guy a little D3 love as a former D3 player myself. Love seeing that at the AHL level. He certainly had a much more prolific career at D3 than I did, which is why he's down there and I'm up here. 1 minute to go here in the third. Del Mastro weaves one into Sorella. Sorella gets it back. He has one of the three tonight for Rockford. Back to the blue line. Del Mastro finds Maniscalco, blocked by Miller. Now Del Mastro lost the puck with 34 to go in the man advantage for Rockford. And a clear by Masters after a nice read to intercept the pass. Spodniak back with it. Clamoring in on him is Conley. Johansson, a good hit on Spodniak. The clear by Spacek, met by the left knee of McDougal, who gets it back, winds and unloads, blocked in front. Another nice battle won by Simon Johansson. And Dornbach's clearing attempt deflected out of play. Well, Simon Johansson, if there is one thing that he has been talked to about by coaching staff, by the development team of Minnesota, who's here tonight, Brad Bombardier, Matt Hendricks, and Cody McLeod, it is one-on-one battles. Johansson is smooth. He can move the puck, had 12 assists last season. He's a great skater, but those hard areas, the net front, is where Simon Johansson has been tasked with getting better. I've seen it tonight. 9 seconds to go in the third period. Ross McDougal will dash ahead, trying for one last door prize. Nardella at the buzzer. One more save for Jesper. And a perfect preseason for Iowa. They win 7-3 tonight. And it was offense abound all week long as the Wild will prepare for a date with the Henderson Silver Knights on home opening night next weekend. And they'll go into that night with oodles of confidence, especially with the offense. 13 total goals scored in the preseason. Lots to look forward to for this Wild club as we gear up for the 11th regular season in team history beginning on Friday night. We'll take a breath and come back. And one of our stars of the game, Sammy Walker, is set to join us. He'll likely have to give out a souvenir, though. He's going to be one of the stars of the game tonight. He'll chat with us when we come back here in the postgame show next on YouTube.
Feeling of loading up the night before. Punching the season's first hole. The feel of the jig as it flutters on the fall. And the exhilaration of seeing real-life monsters appear. Game on is getting closer. Are you ready? Shields. Are tipped and the crew's assembled. May the heavy lifting begin. It's time to walk on water. Shields.
Clogbusters! What? Clogbusters is the only premier drain cleaning service company in Central Iowa. From drain assessments to sewer repair, Clogbusters will make sure the job is done with care and quality in mind to make sure it's done right. Our pet-friendly team will always provide the care you deserve, and we can offer a 2-year warranty. Don't wait until the problem gets worse. Call us today at 265-CLOCK. Again, 265-CLOCK to schedule an appointment.
Welcome back to the postgame show, hockey fans, here at Wells Fargo Arena. A 6-3 victory for the Wild. They score 13 times in the preseason. And one of those customers who was up to the task of offense tonight, he has been almost every night of his young Iowa Wild career. Sammy Walker is with us now down on the bench. A goal and two assists tonight, Sammy. Welcome back. Was that fun?
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Although it was two goals and assists, I think.
Look at that. Was it two and an assist? It's preseason for me too, buddy. Yeah. Leave me alone.
Well, I'm just
Sammy,
messing.
A big night for you guys, obviously. And I said this to Vinny Letteri too when we chatted during the second intermission. It's preseason, but it's still fun to score like this. What have you noticed about the offense and maybe what's different this season with Brett McClain at the helm?
Yeah. No, it's awesome. I mean, it's a good vibe. And, I mean, like you said, it's fun scoring goals no matter what game it is, whether it's on the pond or in your driveway. And it was fun to get a win tonight. So we just got to keep rolling.
Vinny Letteri, Nick Petan, Sammy Walker. Fans should get used to hearing that, at least as long as all of you guys are here. I know you're a part of probably the top echelon of call-ups that the Minnesota Wild will have this season. What did you notice about the chemistry you had with these three in a very early sample size of what could be a fabulous line when you guys are paired together?
Yeah, I know, it's awesome. I mean, you got two guys that are just unbelievable passers. So, I mean, I just try to get open for them. We've been playing well together, so hopefully we can keep that up.
Sammy, congrats on a big night, and we'll look forward to starting for real come Friday evening.
Yeah, thank you.
That's Sammy Walker with two goals and an assist. I double-checked it while I was off camera. Sammy was right. I was wrong. I beg your forgiveness. I humbly beg for your forgiveness at home. But what a fun evening we had of hockey here tonight. And this is a Wild team that obviously has a lot of great offensive upside, and we're looking forward to seeing what they can bring come Friday night. Let's bring John Schaefer back into the fold here tonight as we'll put the dual screens up on your feed. John, let's start talking about this hockey game. You and I don't get to do this post game very often because
no.
I'm usually on the KXNO side. What were your thoughts?
You know, I thought it was a really good sign of what's to come this season, and like I had talked about in that second intermission report, I texted my dad, said this is a team that can score seven goals and they might give up a lot defensively this year just because of how young they are. We saw that a little bit in the third. Certainly something Coach McClain wants to clean up, but at the same time, you're not overly mad about it because you want this team to face a little bit of adversity. You want these young guys to realize this is no longer college hockey or major juniors. This is a game where teams can score and score quickly, just as quick as your team can.
I couldn't agree with you more, and I talked about it a bit during the third period there. This did feel like a pretty good representation of, at least early, what we might see. Offense, check, big check, lots of checks. They can score, but they might give up goals in rapid succession, at least early in the season. There's no question the ceiling of the likes of a Masters, a Lambos, a Spotcheck, they're very high. But still, these are 20-year-old players playing in a men's league. This is an absolute high-end, veteran-led league of high-end players that even though you may not be household names at the AHL, it's the second-best league in the world. There's a big learning curve to get to the American League level for these young players, and they're going to chip in. They're going to create offense. Carson Lambos had a great night, but there were still mistakes he made. There were mistakes Spotcheck made. There were mistakes that Masters made as well. There were also mistakes older guys made. There's mistakes made every single night. So we might see a lot of this season, at least early on. Now, the big question I have, and it's the question we won't be able to answer until after Christmas, what do those three look like after Christmas? What do Simon Johansson and Ryan O'Rourke, who are in their second full seasons pro, what do they look like after Christmas? Because the difference to me in an Iowa Wild team that is just fun to watch and is offensive and is entertaining and a true contender is how much room, how much closer to their ceilings can these young defensemen get after the break? Because that's when teams start to separate. It looks like Iowa's going to have no trouble scoring this season. It looks like these young defensemen are going to have no trouble creating offense this season. But can they shore up the defensive side of the game? Can they learn those little nuances, what it's like to be a pro? And will they wilt come game 40, 50, 60, or will they start to succeed and excel in those times? The good news is all three of those players we're talking about come from major junior. You look at a guy like Sammy Walker last year, he comes out of college, different schedule. They played maybe 40 games. In Major Junior, you're playing, I think it's 65, 70 games a season, so they might be a little more built to last later in the year. Sammy did a lot of his heavy lifting early in the year. He was one of the top scorers in the league in the first half. Just still kept scoring down the stretch, but not at the levels we saw at the beginning of the season because it's hard to score all year long. So I'm excited to see what this trio on the back end has in store, and I'm excited to see what this team certainly has in store because the storyline of the preseason right now is offensive depth and potency.
Absolutely, and Ben, get out of my head, man. You were thinking exactly what I was with some of these young guys because you hit on it very well with Sammy Walker. Kind of fizzled. I don't want to say fizzled necessarily, but lost maybe a little bit, half a step there as the game start to wear on you. Again, you said it. This is a man's game now. It's not a kid's game. It's not major juniors. It is certainly a game that is physical, heavy hockey at times, and then we saw that really against Coachella Valley late in the season. And so it was certainly a team that I think is going to continue to develop. They have some veteran leaders on that offense. I think Dakota Mermis will also play a critical role in keeping these guys fresh, keeping them moving forward and realizing, like, guys, this is how you have to take care of your body now at 20-21 as a professional versus being the college kid where, you know, you've got a little bit more access to the dining halls. It wasn't my friend. It was a little bit more their friend. But at the same time, Ben, I think this is a team that has a ton of depth. I think this is an exciting team and one that deserves to get back into the playoff picture and should be back in the playoff picture by all accounts. Veteran goaltending anchors everything that they do. Goaltenders can steal games. They can also cost you games, but they can steal games. We saw that frequently, especially toward the end of the year with the Wild team last year, too.
Big nights for Nick Patan, who had 3 assists. Sammy Walker, 2 goals and an assist officially, as he loved to point out. I can't wait to talk to him after the game about that. Hey, he was right. Hey, he called me out.
Not wrong,
no. Totally should have. And the first star of the game, Vinny Letteri with a goal and 3 assists. If
fun team to watch.
If that line is here, it will be really, really fun to watch them play together. And so we'll see what happens. We'll see what it looks like. Don't forget, we talked about it, no Jujhar Kara tonight.
Yep.
And no Stephen Fogarty tonight. So where do they fit in? There's not enough room for all of these high-octane offensive players. There quite simply is not enough room on a given lineup to dress 12 forwards. So we'll see how this all shakes out once it starts for real next weekend. John, any final thoughts before we put a lid on this broadcast?
No, just really excited to see what Coach McLean dials up. Night one, hope there's a great crowd on hand. Again, thanks for tuning into YouTube TV. If you're still with us in our postgame show, join us on AHL TV. Special thing we do here with the Iowa Wild, one of the few, if not only, programs in all of the AHL to do this. So a lot of fun with you, Benny. Looking forward to a great home season.
Right back at you, John. A big thank you to John Schaefer, as well as Jake Anderson and Zach Stone producing tonight. And to all of you for joining us here this evening from Wells Fargo Arena. Offense, offense, offense. That's the headline. The Wild have plenty of it this season, and we'll look to see more of it, hopefully, coming your way next weekend, Friday night, 7 p.m. here at Wells Fargo Arena. If you're in town, get your tickets. If you're not, subscribe to AHL TV so you can tune into our opening night broadcast on Friday night with the Henderson Silver Knights in town. But tonight, the preseason ends perfectly, a 6-3 victory and 13 total goals in the preseason. We'll see if this high-octane offense continues into the regular season come next weekend. Until then, thanks for joining our broadcast tonight. I'm Ben Gislason bidding you a fond farewell and good night from downtown Des Moines.